Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory with a little discussion on rat rods, the anatomy of the rat. As you know by now, we love rat rods and we build them all the time. And it's only fitting now that we're building two shiny and graphic full lowriders that we start to chomp at the bit for building some more rat rods. Anyway, I just had these three handy, you know, the 1950 Chevy pickup, of course, the 1937, I want to say, Ford, 36 Ford, 37 Ford, 38 Ford, lose track. And then, of course, the 32, Ford High Boy, which I love. And this was a very fun build last year for me. I had a great time doing it. And, and it's a kit that comes with all these goodies here. You know, I scratch built. It doesn't come with the amp. That I scratch built, and it turned out just beautiful. Nothing says hot rod, rat rod more than, red and black. So, satin, a little gunky, a little gone, you know, and that's just sewing thread that I turned into the little cable. Again, watch parts are the way to go. You know, I still have to add a couple of little plug thingies there, those jacks. But anyway, by now you should know what a rat rod is, and if you don't, you know, there's plenty. Just go to Google image and punch in rat rod and your head will explode. We love building them. I think the main requirement for a rat rod is just to think outside the box and just have fun. And again, I build them because to relieve myself from the stress of having to build shiny. And it's a great way to sort of do a quick build, low stress. And I think a lot of you have already tried building them. And if you're not having fun, then I don't know. But you can look in the magazines for research, all of that good stuff. Lately I've been doing the patinaed or rat rod sort of gunky, rusty with... you know, a fairly immaculate and clean engine. I kind of like that. So, you know, you could just have a lot of fun. Of course, that engine here is gunky because that's the way we like them. But you know, you can have so much fun adding details to your builds. And to your engines, just have a great old time doing it, you know. Let me see if I can move in a little bit here. There we go. Much better. So basically the sky is the limit, so to speak. You know, you can spend the rest of your days as a builder building rat rods. I recommend it. It's a lot of fun. It'll put hair on your chest. But they're just, again, they're fun. I think in the real world, a lot of people love building rat rods because it just gives them that sense of freedom and reconnects them back to the spirit of hot rodding, you know, finding a junker and fixing it up as you went and loving every minute of it, you know. Well, us who build scale models, we get the same feeling by building these rat rods, you know. So, just have fun with them, and as I said, it gives you a little alternative, a little variety, you know, and you can have a lot of fun doing them, and I think you're going to end up growing as a builder because of it. So if you haven't tried your hand at one, try your hand at one. It's and also you can look through the archives for the different techniques, you know, the salting, the chipping, the weathering, the sponging. We've done those videos, and luckily they're in the archives, or you can check them out in Dr. Kranke's book, but they're there, and they're fun, and so, anyway, I thought I'd share some of these with you and talk a little bit about rat rods and how much fun they are. It's an acquired taste. Not everybody's into them, and that's fine. You know, I respect that. But I love them for the simple reason that they do spice the work at the bench. So whether they're trucks or coupes or convertibles, you know, you could try your hand at. I know builders who've even tried rat rotting semis. Why the heck not? Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, and let me know. Keep in touch and keep up the good work. Remember, long live styrene, my friends.